From Kmart in South Minneapolis to Kazmarchex in Northeast, the new streetcar line in Minneapolis got the go-ahead from the City Council today. The City Council approved spending $60 million to start the first leg of the streetcar project. The total price tag, though, for the three-mile line is $200 million. Our Jay Coles is live in Minneapolis, and Jay, how is the city paying for its portion?
Well, Leah, that's where the city is sort of taking a leap of faith. You see, the money would come from developments, current and new developments, that would run along the streetcar line, which would travel right here over the Hennepin Avenue Bridge. But here's the catch. If those new developments were to fail, then Minneapolis taxpayers are partially on the hook for them.
So the ghosts of streetcars past are one step closer to moving through Minneapolis in real time, if all the funding kicks in as planned. And some cannot wait to hear the sounds of the streetcars from Hennepin and University all the way down to Kmart at Lake and Nicollet.
Tens of millions of dollars on football stadiums that I'm never going to go to. Why not spend a little money on a streetcar that I'll ride and enjoy?
I think it helps the city develop. I think it makes people want to come into the city. It helps people want to live in the city to be able to go from place to place, and it might eliminate some of these cars.
So it all sounds good, but this is a new way of using public money on a transportation project that has not been tested here before. The city will use public dollars to fund a public project. The hope is private development will grow around the streetcar line, and the city would then use money from the increased property tax values to pay off the loan for the streetcars. But some don't think that makes good economic sense.
With everything we're doing with light rail, I think it's not a good investment. We have enough public transportation now with buses and the bike rides and the other things. We don't need streetcars.
Now, the city hopes to raise the additional $140 million by getting a regional partner, maybe state government, maybe the Metropolitan Council, or maybe the federal government. But right now, no government entity has stepped up and publicly pledged support for this project. And one other issue that's got to be resolved is right here on the Hennepin Avenue Bridge. It's not clear yet whether this street is wide enough to handle the expansion that would be needed for the streetcars, or if it would need to be reinforced. Reporting live in Minneapolis, Jay Coles, 5 Eyewitness News.